Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Victor once again, and today I am wearing my Kamchatka t-shirt. If you don't know what Kamchatka is, Kamchatka is a region located in the far east of the Russian Federation, 8 hours away by plane from the capital, Moscow. Last year, due to coronavirus, we were not able to go abroad because we were not allowed. So we wanted to go somewhere very far, and Kamchatka was the furthest we could get last year. So that's why we went to this place. It's a peninsula, by the way, not far away from Japan, to the north of Japan. It was absolutely beautiful. If there was a word to describe Kamchatka, I would say pristine. I would like so much to share my memories with all of you, but I don't want to be talking. Let me show you the place.
Last year, amid the coronavirus pandemic, the world was absolutely paralyzed, and traveling abroad was not allowed whatsoever. However, thanks to God, Russia is the biggest country in the world, and we had many options and destinations where to go. For us, Kamchatka was the best option, as it is extremely exotic and very far away. What makes it special is that few people know about it. Before landing, we had this spectacular view from the airplane, just as if we were flying over the fjords in Norway. The highest mountain you see is Volcano Koryatsky. This is what gives an impressive and natural skyline to Pietropavlovsk, which is the capital of the peninsula. Apparently, this volcano has been active for 10,000 years. Pietropavlovsk is the capital of the peninsula, Kamchatka, but rather than a city, this place looks more like a town, a very small town. Pietropavlovsk has a population of less than 200,000 people, and its name literally means Peter and Paul. You can see the range of volcanoes from almost everywhere in the city. Right at this point, we were heading to the local market, as we had heard that caviar was very affordable, and of course, this is a local product in Kamchatka. Unfortunately, I don't have videos of the market, but I do have pictures. Later that day, we decided to go to see the bay and just to walk along the beach, and it was very relaxing. It is almost impossible to believe that the last time we had seen the Pacific Ocean, it had been in Chile, in South America, and right there we were in the other side of the world and still seeing the same ocean. On our second day in Kamchatka, we decided to buy a tour to go sailing on a boat. For me, it was extremely magical to go on a nice boat with other people sailing the Pacific Ocean. For me, that was priceless. At this point, I was thinking that I had also seen the Pacific Ocean in Nicaragua, the same as in Chile. And I thought it was very special to see the same ocean from different points of the world. The dream is finally wake up. Don't wake me, I'm not dreaming. Don't wake me, I'm not dreaming. I would like to share a beautiful thought with you. Do you remember the film Free Willy from 1993? I don't know why, but the environment and the nature of this place was just making me think constantly about this film I watched when I was a child. I thought this was very similar to Scandinavia. On board, we had a nice salmon soup and Kamchatsky crabs as lunch. A third day was a little bit more humble, so we just tried to go on a bike around the city. Unfortunately, at the end of our excursion on the boat, I started vomiting and that wasn't very nice. That's why that day we wanted to stay inland far away from the sea. That day wasn't a real success neither, because you are going to see what happened. Yes, I nearly killed myself. I just fell down horribly from the bike. I feel so happy when I am surrounded by nature. I needed so much to be in a place like this. I had been 45 days on my own due to coronavirus, because in Moscow we had had a very strict lockdown.
Looking up at a tree, I remember how it started.
Bueno, ahora mismo estamos. So right now we are like the forest walking. We are going to the Blue Lakes, which is like a natural resort, like in the forest, like next to the mountains. That day we had to walk 15 kilometers to the lakes and 15 kilometers back. Imagine 30 in total. Hi.
Hi. Look at what berries we have. These are berries that the...
Can you? So basically this is what we just got from the bushes.
Пойдем. А, еще.
Кого уменьшу? Риза уменьшу.
Сейчас это у меня... Ай, москита! Ай,
Our guy had just told us that we had to be aware just in case a bear came out from nowhere, imagine. And he also told us that it was okay if we drank water from the brook. The water you see flowing down the mountains, it comes directly from the lakes. I have to be sincere with you. The guy told us that there had been a few attacks by bears in the whole entire peninsula and that it was extremely dangerous, but we still wanted to do it. And this is what we saw up there. As you can see, on our fourth day we went horse riding, something that we really wanted to do for such a long time, and we finally did it in Kamchatka. To go through this beautiful field of flowers was just like living a fantasy. It was absolutely gorgeous and magical. Richly was very worried because he was struggling to control his horse. I was very concerned. In my case, it wasn't that difficult because I had done it previously. And the mare I was riding was very docile and serene. Our fifth day was a bit of a spa day. We just went to the горячие источники. In English, this is to the hot springs. Kamchatka has hot springs everywhere due to its volcanic activity. On day 6, we went to see the Koryaki people. They are the native inhabitants of the peninsula. They performed a welcoming dance, typical in their tribes. Do you know that these people share the same genes with the Native Americans in the American continent? This is not a surprise, of course, because everyone knows that their ancestors went through the Bering Sea to America. After that lovely performance, we were allowed to feed the reindeer. And by the way, I spoke with them to persuade Santa to bring me a good and big gift for Christmas. We had such a lovely time that day in the countryside, and later on we did something even more fun, just wait and see. A few minutes later, the real fun started. They had a very interesting activity in this farm. We were on a summer sled pulled by dogs, imagine, just like in the films. I let Richley go first to video record him. That activity was so fun because the dogs will basically take you through the forest, and that was extremely wild. Then it was my turn. And this is where we came to say goodbye to this wonderful place, Kamchatka, just in front of the ocean, the Pacific Ocean, my old friend. I would like to thank a lovely couple we met in Kamchatka. They were so kind with us, and I'm so grateful to them. So guys, this was the end of our adventure in Kamchatka. Please, if you liked the video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up. Take care and wait for more. Dreaming. Don't wake me, I'm not dreaming.